In high school, I took 4 AP courses. I enjoyed them all and did well in each of them. But when the time came to take the AP test, I only had 1 credit transfer into college. And that 1 credit didn't even do me any good because of the way that my college structures their core classes. Why didn't my AP credits transfer in when my grades were fine? Well, I could make up an excuse and tell you that it was because the test was super hard or something like that. And disclaimer, there was 1 class where the AP was much harder than it should have been, and it knows which one it was. In all seriousness though, I would argue that it was because I wasn't invested in passing the AP. I had 6 other classes I had to pass in a school that I didn't enjoy for various reasons that we're not really going to get into in this video. So now we get into the question, why did I take the AP classes? Well, originally I didn't. I saw the caliber of education I was getting in the non-AP courses, and I knew that I wanted to learn more than George Washington was the first president of the United States. I wanted a better education than the standard classes offered. And what else did my school district provide? AP courses. So that's what I got. For me, it was never about getting college credit. It was about getting a good education so that I could get into my dream college. In my opinion, the school district I went to did a lot of things wrong. From authoritarian supervision, to limiting students' ability to get quality time with teachers during school hours, to pushing a major renovation that was much needed without taking the quality time and having quality conversations with students and teachers to see what they needed, to filtering the internet, arguably the biggest source of information in the world, down to just a fraction of what was useful, and not even teaching students how to use their phones and the internet productively. There were a lot of missteps. But the biggest, in my opinion, is abandoning electives. You can weigh kids down with AP courses and give them study halls, and that might look good on paper. But just like tests, it's not preparing them for life after college. It's just working them to death. That also filters out an entire body of students who, for lack of a better term, don't like school. Pushing APs lets those students who don't like school sit back in the general classes and goof off, effectively leaving them in the dust. And that's where electives come in. Those students that hate school generally look forward to electives. Those are the classes that let them be who they want to be. Those are the classes that show them that they're competent students. And most importantly, those are the classes that let them succeed. For me, those are the classes that let me harness my dream. Since I've been little, I've wanted to be a broadcast meteorologist. Mr. Goble, Ms. Davidson, and Mr. Watterson, and Mr. Pekka led me there. And when I say there, I'm a freshman in my dream college, triple majoring in broadcasting meteorology and mathematics. I'm in my dorm room, standing in front of a green screen I built myself, working for a global student news group, publishing videos that explain global warming. That is literally my dream for where I am in life. And my electives led me there. And I'm not saying that AP courses can't be students' dreams, because they totally can. But there's a difference between students who can succeed in AP classes in high school and the students that can't. And we shouldn't leave those students who can't behind. We need to start taking electives that aren't study hall more seriously, and Ladue has the potential to be just that. As a school that's always on the forefront of new ways to learn, this needs to be where we focus our energy next. Thanks for watching. I'm Ian Mason, Ladue graduate, class of 2017.